हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू रियल लिटरेचर एंड रैंडम वीडियोस बाय नेहा सुल्ताना। फाइनली ये मेरा फोर्थ पोएम है, फैसेट ऑफ यूनियन। सो इन दिस पीस वी डेल्व इनटू द ट्रबलिंग डायनामिक्स ऑफ अ मैट्रिमोनियल बॉन्ड फॉर्ज्ड अंडर फॉल्स प्रिटेंसेस। The narrative unravels the facet of a union where deceit and material greed overshadow, you know, genuine affection. Here we explore the journey of a bride who, despite her earnest expectations, faces the harsh reality of a groom whose true intentions are unraveled post-wedding. Through this tale, we confront the societal pressures and power imbalances that plague many relationships, emphasizing the importance of, equality and respect in marriage. So join us as we reflect on these themes and advocate for a partnership rooted in mutual respect and truth. So let's jump to the poem. So I don't know how it is going to sound when I read this poem. It's my fourth poem. I hope you all like it. If you really like this video, then please do subscribe to my channel and like the video, share the video as much as you can. Okay, let's jump to the video. Year after year, you sought a maiden fair, fostering bonds with her kin with care. Yet in forging ties, deceit's the sweet seed you sow. Fostering bonds with her kin with care, yet in forging ties, deceit's seeds you sow. With falsehoods, this connection you bestow, formalizing the commitment and exchanging vows. With falsehoods, this connection you bestow, formalizing the commitment and exchanging vows. Throughout the courtship, you solicited wealth, gold, bike, and every treasure not present within your own abode. Throughout the courtship, you solicited wealth, gold, bike, and every treasure not present within your own abode. Now she has arrived at your residence having wedded you. Escort her forthwith and refrain from ever causing her any distress regarding conspiracies. Now she has arrived at your residence having wedded you. Escort her forthwith and refrain from ever causing her any distress regarding conspiracies. Having dealt with all that regarding the girl's side, now he is sitting with hopes pinned on business. Having dealt with all that regarding the girl's aside, now he is sitting with hopes pinned on business. When the bride's father fails to induce the boy into commerce, the very lad who spent years courting and selecting the girl now unveils his authentic nature. When the bride's father fails to induce the boy into commerce, the very lad who spent years courting and selecting the girl now unveils his authentic nature. Until now, the discussion was about the useless groom. Now it will be about the earner. Until now, the discussion was about the useless groom. Now it will be about the earner. Even earners get married with a dowry. As far as I have observed others' relations, I have only witnessed servitude in them. Even earners get married with a dowry. As far as I have observed others' relations, I have only witnessed servitude in them. The breadwinners in the family tend to perceive their family members as servile. The breadwinners in the family tend to perceive their family members as servile. The They say at every turn and remind you that if I weren't with you, you wouldn't be anywhere today. They say at every turn that remind you that if I weren't with you, you wouldn't be anywhere today. They say at every turn and remind you that if I weren't with you, you wouldn't be anywhere today. I assert that in matrimonial bonds, both parties are equal. There is no superiority or inferiority. So what reason do you have for arrogance? I assert that in matrimonial bonds, both parties are equal. There is no superiority or inferiority. So what reason do you have arrogance for? Do not pride yourself on the fact that you earn. Do not pride yourself on the fact that you earn. Do not pride yourself on the fact that you earn. If you earn, she also manages the household. Children don't consume money. If you earn, she also manages the household. Children don't consume money. If you earn, she also manages the household. Children don't consume money. I am aware that you take pride in masculinity at home and in front of women, sometimes by striking, sometimes by humiliating. I am aware that you take pride in masculinity at home and in front of women, sometimes by striking, sometimes by humiliating. I say, what masculinity is there in boasting about someone who has built your home? I say, what masculinity is there in boasting about someone who has built your home? But this is something that one whose mind is in his knees cannot understand. But this is something that one whose mind is in his knees cannot understand. But this is something that one whose mind is in his knees cannot understand. To be continued. So if you really like this poem, then please give a lot a thumbs up and share the video and do comments also. See you in the next video. Bye bye.